In this session, what we are going to see is how to create a bill of materials in SAP. For that, we are going to start with our demo case. This is a case that we are going to follow on in following lessons to see how the production planning and production process works in this small example. In this case, what we are going to use is a simple bill of materials to fabricate, to manufacture a bicycle. It is going to be called bike RNA. RNA is going to be like the brand or the model. And it's going to have the basic components a typical basic bicycle has, like two wheels, have two wheels. One chain group where it is going to be constituted by the chain, two pedals and the gear, one frame, the metallic part that is going to join wheels, seat and handlebar, the seat and the handlebar. So let's go to the SAP and see how we would create this structure. The maintenance of bill of materials is in the standard menu of SAP in logistics, production, master data, bill of materials, material BOM. Here we can access to create, change or display a bill of materials. We go to create. What we are going to create in the first place is going to be the BOM for the bike. So we are going to use to enter the material number of the material for which we are going to create the BOM, the plant in which this BOM is going to be used, the usage, as we are going to produce it, we are going to use the production usage, number one. So we enter to the bill of material. As we see in the upper frame, we can see that the material we have just entered, the plant and the alternative BOM, that this will only be used in cases where we can manufacture the same material, the same bike in this case, with different materials. So we can have different BOMs for the same finished good or semi-finished good. If you go to this button, to the head, we can see head related data. Here we can see we can enter a test. We are going to call it head test. Just a description or explanation of how this BOM is assembled or some characteristics of it. The base quantity, this is the quantity to which are going to be related the quantities, the component quantities that are going to be entered. So when we enter the quantities of components, they are going to be the needed quantities for manufacturing one unit of this bike. Okay. We can create this BOM in an inactive status, and in this way it won't be allowed to use in a production order or in other functions. This can be useful for instance when engineering department is creating it, but they don't want that this BOM is yet used in the production environment, in the production function. We're going to leave one. We can have different further data as the labor office. In the administration data tab, we can see when it was created, from which date is valid. Here, when we save, it's going to appear at the date in which was created and for whom, by whom. And we can assign documents if we want. If we come back to the general item overview, here we see different columns with different numbers, each one for each line, where we can enter the different components. One important field is the item category, where we can enter if we are using components that are going to be consumed and that are managed in stock, or if we can enter, for instance, documents that are going to join this structure, or tests just for indications in the production, etc. For this example, for this simple example, we are going to use only stock items. So here now we have to enter the different components of this bike. As we saw, we are going to have wheels. So we enter the component, the material number for the wheel, and we need two wheels in each bicycle. So we enter two. This is the unit of measure that is going to be brought from the material master. We have already created all these materials, so we can enter them now. This is a previous step that they are created in the same way as we saw how to create the wheel material, and we are going to see now these materials. So we also have a frame, as we saw in the slide. We need one frame. We need one seat. So we enter one seat. We have a handlebar. And we have a chain group. These are the components that are in the first level of this structure. At this moment, we are not going to enter yet the components that are in, below the chain group, that form the chain group, as they are going to be created in a different bill of material. We are going to see it next. So we press enter to validate, and we see how the unit of measure is got from the material master. We can see the different materials we have created. This was the one that we created in the material master BOM. If we double click, we go to the material master, and here we see the different data we entered when we created it. If we go back, we can check now the frame. This was created in the same way. Pressing this information button, we can see this is a raw material. This is an important field. We go back. The same for the seat, with all the different data. The same for the handlebar. And in the case of the chain group, what is different is that this has a different material type. It's called HALF. That is going to be a semi-finished product, as it has a bill of materials below it. So we come back to this bill of materials. And now what we can see is the details of each of these components in this bill of materials. So if we double click in the item number, we can see more information about this component in this bill of material. We see this was already entered in the previous screen. We see the quantity. Here we can add different scrap figures that what they are going to do is to calculate more quantity than it is required, taking into account that some of the units are going to be scrapped. So MRP could take into account this percentage in good planned in SX. We have different data, as we can define one component as a co-product, especially in chemical processes where it is some output from the manufacturing process. We can use different special procurements. For instance, we can use phantom assemblies that assemblies that are not going to be used, are not going to be stored, but we want them to be as a different bond level. We can enter some tests, the same as we entered in the at the header level. Here we We can add some explanation text or description. In case we want to use a different storage location than the one we enter in the material master, this would be the storage location from which this material is going to be consumed by default. When we create a production order and when we consume materials to that production order. When we save, we are going to have automatically fill these fields, and we can assign different documents to this component, to this position in the bill of materials. So we can just save, and at this moment we are going to see a message in the bottom that says that this bill of material has been created. We can do the same for the chain group. If we are in the create material BOM screen, we can enter the chain group material. The same as before, we can see the alternative, the usage, the description text, and for one quantity, for one unit, we are going to enter the different components. One chain, two pedals, and one gear. Exactly the same, we press enter and we can save. So at this moment, we have created all this structure. We come back. We can check what we have created. We can enter to change it. And here we can see an important field, this, that it's telling us this is an assembly. And if we double click here, we accept, we see that this is the BOM of this assembly or semi-finished, the change group. And this is all for this session.